Hey, before we get started, I just wanted to make it clear that I do not condone the harassment of any individuals that appear in this video. Don't do that, please. Thanks. So it's no secret that I've been working on a massive new video on Bloober Team's game, The Medium, for years at this point, because time is a flat circle and life is hell. Subscribe for that video now if you want to be the first to complain about how long it ends up being. Well, during this time, I've uncovered interesting information regarding The Medium's development, as well as Bloober Team's history, and in early 2023, I discovered that one of the developers who worked on The Medium and subsequently left Bloober under suspicious circumstances had liked transphobic and racist tweets, heavily implying they potentially harbored transphobic and racist views. I told my Discord about the situation in June, and a regular there named Redrum Dumdum brought the issue up with the dev directly. This started a chain reaction where the dev began deleting their problematic likes, so I made a call-out post on my twitter.com letting everyone know the kind of person you'd be supporting if you bought the dev's upcoming game. That developer was Artur Wonchowski, and that upcoming game was Stray Souls.
Not like I'm gonna get any sleep now.
So yeah, it turns out one of the worst games of 2023 was made by an
alleged
racist transphobe. Shocking, I know. I'm sure the people on my call-out tweet who said they were gonna buy the game specifically to support the devs
alleged
dogshit views had a fantastic time and don't feel ripped off at all. Anyway, why am I talking about this old news? Well, two reasons. First, documentation. After Stray Souls bombed immediately upon release, Artur released an apology for liking those racist and transphobic tweets, both via his Jukai Studios account, the company he released the game under, and his personal Twitter account. Here it is. What's that? It's too blurry? Oh, yeah, let me find a higher quality version. Oh wait, I can't because he fucking deleted it. He deleted his apology. Nothing says I'm sorry better than deleting the time that you said I'm sorry. But maybe it was for the best. After all, Artur was clearly
possibly
lying at multiple points in his apology, one of which was preserved by Sissel the Cat on Twitter when she said, "A more immature version of myself. Dude, the likes were from May. Shut the fuck up and eat your terrible game." Speaking of
potential
lies, at multiple points during the lead up to Stray Souls' release, Artur stated over and over again that he never liked those tweets that I called him out for. Despite photo and video evidence that he liked those tweets, he never liked those tweets. He said in interviews,
"I've never liked any kind of transphobic or racist tweets, simply because I am not that kind of person. I have nothing but respect for all kind of people. I work with people that are identifying as a LGBTQ plus and are different skin color than mine."
At one point, he even accused me of fabricating this whole situation, that I was the one who was lying. So it was kind of a relief when he fessed up. But the evidence that he did is now a goddamn blurry mess, because at the end of the day,
it appears
that Artur is
possibly
banking on no one paying attention. And about a month after Stray Souls released, he deleted his entire Twitter account. So yeah, that's part of the reason I'm making this video, to archive this whole stupid situation and hold Artur accountable. So if he ever decides to make a video game in the future, you, the consumer, can make an educated decision on how you spend your money. Which brings me to the second reason for making this video. Artur is making a new game called Super Normal. I was tipped off to this a few weeks ago by an anonymous source on Twitter who is close to the situation. Looking into the game, it has all the telltale signs of Artur. Namely, that it's not original, at all. Stray Souls was a Silent Hill knockoff right down to involving Akira Yamaoka, who I'm sure is very happy with how things turned out. Stray Souls also heavily ripped off PT, from the kid in Silent Hill's concept trailer, to basing the story on PT's radio broadcast. Plus, it's got the mark of quality for modern games. AI art. Isn't it beautiful? This is also probably a good time to mention that Artur first made a name for himself in the indie horror scene, and possibly even scored his job at Bloober Team for his recreation of Hideo Kojima's PT for PC. What's wrong with that? Nothing. Just that he charged people money to play it by exclusively hosting it on his Patreon. Oh, also, he added himself to the ending of PT in addition to a plug for his Patreon. Anyway, where Supernormal innovates is how it obfuscates its unoriginality by not being a spiritual successor to PT, but rather being a spiritual successor to Allison Road. See, that's technically better, because Allison Road billed itself as a spiritual successor to PT back when it was revealed in July of 2015. So Supernormal is really a spiritual successor to a spiritual successor, and whoops, words have lost all meaning. Supernormal is an official spiritual successor, though, because Artur got permission to make the game from the original creator of Allison Road, Christian Kessler, on Facebook. This fact is being used to promote the game, so I reached out to Christian with some questions, and despite his very busy schedule, he kindly replied to me almost instantly and confirmed that the dev of the game is indeed Artur Wanchowski. He also seemed confused about Artur blatantly ripping off his antagonist from Allison Road. Quote, "I didn't quite realize inspired by means he's just going to recreate the character, lol." So that's basically the situation as it stands right now. Artur Wanchowski pulled a fantastic and is now actively running away from his mistakes, attempting to hide behind a new project and hoping no one finds out. A few weeks ago, Artur released a statement on his Jukai Studio account announcing its closure and vaguely threatening to sue someone? Some cyber persecutor whose terrible crime seems to be sending people unwanted messages and emails. Ah, well, that explains why Stray Souls turned out to be hot garbage, doesn't it? All those goddamn emails. You know, part of me wants to end this video on a hopeful note. Like, some gullible section of my brain wants to plead with Artur to just stop running away, to undelete his Twitter and repost the apology so he might actually learn something from this whole ordeal and become a better, more honest person eventually. To realize the pain he's putting out into the world by boosting racist and transphobic hate. But another part of me hopes he leaves the game dev space and never comes back, and that's the part of me that knows about Artur's first original game, Cold World. See, Redrum has been helping me with research on this video. Thank you very much for your help, by the way, Red. At one point during the creation of this video, Redrum decided to reach out to a former coworker of Artur's, who goes by Shadow's Fate. Shadow's Fate proved to be a wealth of knowledge about how Artur operated specifically with regard to his 2018 title Cold World, a game about a rookie cop investigating a crime scene. Think Resident Evil without zombies and really bad jump scares.
Police! Come out now!
Anyway, Shadow's Fate was the voice actor for the game's main character, though he says he helped out with the plot too, but Artur threw out most of his contributions. Watching a playthrough of the game on YouTube, I was taken aback by one scene in particular. By the way, I've censored this scene myself. The original is fully uncensored. Can't spell Artur without art, I guess. So when Shadow's Fate said I might be shocked by something in the game, I initially thought he was talking about this hacky schlock. Unfortunately, he wasn't. Warning, the following content is serious and deals with sexual assault. Skip to the timecode on your screen now to avoid hearing about the specifics. About 6 minutes into Cold World, your character overhears a phone call. In it, a woman is heard talking to a 911 operator about a man attempting to break into her bedroom. Within the context of the game, this is meant to be the victim of the killer your rookie cop is chasing. The call lasts about a minute and a half, and ends with the man breaking into the woman's room while she screams. You may have noticed that I'm specifically choosing not to play this clip, and that's because it is a real 911 call of a woman being sexually assaulted. I've had to listen to bits and pieces of this call a few times to cross-reference them with a book from 2002 that included an official transcript of it, and honestly, it's going to be a while before I forget this woman, Sharon from Ohio, pleading with her attacker while her baby is in the room. It goes without saying, this is absolutely fucked. Shadow's Fate even went out of his way to find voice actors to record their own dramatized version of the 911 call, but Artur had to include a real person's desperate, haunting screams for his stupid, awful video game. I don't even have words for this, honestly. It takes a special kind of callousness to not see a problem with including a real 911 call in your project that's primarily focused on being entertainment. I won't belabor the point because I'm confident that you get it. So yeah, that's all I have to say about the Artur Wanchowski situation. I'll be reaching out to him on Supernormal's Discord, and if he responds by the time this video goes live, I'll add it here. Hi, Bob from the future here. So I'll try to make this as succinct as I can. During the production of this video, I reached out to the developer of Supernormal, Hitori D Productions, which seems to be Japanese for By Yourself Productions, and asked if they were in fact Artur Wanchowski. I did this on Friday, January 5th at 6:35 a.m. ET, and a few minutes later, Hitori D responded. They denied the accusation, and at 6:46 a.m., they accepted my offer to do an interview to prove they weren't Artur, either later on Friday or at some point on Saturday. At 6:57 a.m., they linked me to a Kotaku article about Jukai Studios being the victim of cyber attacks, because as has been established, pointing out that someone liked racist and transphobic tweets is apparently a cyber attack, and asked if I was connected to it. I explained the situation, and by 7:36 a.m., Hitori backed out of the interview. Our conversation ended with me explaining that I have a lot of evidence that proves they're Artur, and that backing out of an interview that would prove they're not Artur just makes the situation seem more dubious. Hitori asked why I care so much, to which I responded by saying, well, for one thing, I think it's incredibly disingenuous to pretend to be an upstart indie dev with no prior history when you do actually have a pretty bad history making asset-flipped, AI art-riddled games, to say nothing of lying about liking racist-slash-transphobic tweets while attempting to mislead people into thinking I manufactured the entire situation. Also, I've been tipped off that you're attempting to sue me? Is that correct? Hitori responded, I'll get two sides of the story and judge what's going on for myself. What does that mean? It means you shared your version. Now I will ask the Stray Souls folks to see why the fuck I am being included in this whole situation. If you're following along at home, that means, based on all the evidence I have pointing to Hitori D Productions being Artur Wanchowski, that Artur is going to have a chat with Artur. Naturally, I desperately wanted to be included in that conversation, but sadly, it wasn't meant to be. At 3:24 p.m. on that same day, Hitori D Productions blocked me, and Jukai Studio released an open letter accusing me of harassment and threatening legal action. I strongly encourage you to read this letter for yourself and come to your own conclusions about the accusations within. I'll be providing a link in the video description and in the comments. My favorite part is how he tries to blame me for how Stray Souls turned out, though confusing criticism with insulting, mocking, and tormenting is a close second. Like, look at the tweet of mine he used as an example of my harassment. It's literally just me saying the medium is a shitty horror game because it lacks empathy for victims of trauma. Also, for anyone interested, I've never sent a single email to this dude or anyone associated with him, with the single exception of Brian Kessler. I've also never manipulated my close circle into sending anyone emails. Relevant to that, though, I noticed that one person in Jukai's thread signed me up for unlimited spam. Boy, that sure seems like a clear example of someone harassing me with unwanted emails. I'm sure Jukai wouldn't stand for that kind of thing, considering that's the entire premise of his argument against me. Oh, what? Oops, here he is patting on the back. This is the same person that is now attacking friends of mine for completely made up reasons while also signing them up for unlimited spam. And Artur is encouraging them. Nice consistent morals you got there, bud. Kinda looks like you're manipulating your close circle into harassing people from where I'm standing. By the way, I just want to remind everyone, for no reason in particular, that I have proof in various forms that Artur Wanchowski lied about not liking racist and transphobic tweets. He himself admitted to doing so, but has scrubbed that admission from the internet. We are dealing with a proven liar here, and I'm ready and willing to defend that fact in court should it come to that. Which it won't, because these are obviously just hollow threats attempting to scare me into dropping this whole thing. But it seems Artur has the same problem making legal threats as he does making horror games, because I'm just not scared.